for the people's debate in the Dunleary constituency, and we are missing three of the four sitting TDs in the constituency. Sean Barrett can't call a campy with us. Eamon Gilmore, Thornister is not seeking, former Thornister is not seeking re-election. Mary Mitchell O'Connor has decided not to join us, and we're with Richard Boyd Barrett. We also have several of the candidates, but not one from the government parties. But let's start the debate with Richard Boyd Barrett. Richard, why should anybody vote for you, given your record over the last while, since you've had no influence, no power to change anything?
Well, I think what we have done is what we said we'd do, which is fight on and mobilise people and campaign on key issues, which we promised we would do. And I think we've done so, in some cases, quite effectively in pushing the government back. Most obviously, we were involved in instigating the right to water movement, and I think have pushed the government not far enough, but have pushed them back a considerable degree on the issue of water charges. We were instrumental in the successful campaign to stop the government selling off Cuilchire, the public forests. The issue of housing is another key issue. Sadly, we haven't forced the government to change policy, but it's certainly a priority to highlight the absolutely disastrous housing situation and to demand that something urgent is done to deal with it. And obviously on local issues, we fought quite hard on issues like protecting the harbour from what we would see as the threat of privatisation, campaigning to defend local bus services, okay, which are under attack.
OK, one of the issues that the left should be sensitive about, I would have thought, was the issue of taxation, that the left is generally in favour of higher taxes and more and better social services, whereas the right-wing parties are vice versa. And campaigning against water charges and also against the property tax, whereas, of course, water charges were both the way they were introduced, impose further misery on people who can't afford to pay. But generally, the anti-tax agenda that you've run seems to be opportunist and populist.
No, we genuinely believe that we need tax justice and that we don't have it in this country, and that flat charges or user charges disproportionately impact on the less well-off. If the millionaire has to pay the same amount for water services as somebody who's on minimum wage, that is regressive. In that a far bigger proportion of somebody on the lower income, of their income, is going to provide those services. We think a fairer way to pay for services is that you, the more you have, the more you earn, the more you pay.
But isn't it a good idea to have incentives to conserve water, which is an expensive commodity?
Yeah, well, there's absolutely no international evidence to suggest that metering and user charges reduces water use.
Do you need international evidence? Sure, it's obvious that if you're charged for the water you use, you're likely to use less water.
I'm just saying, as a matter of fact, there's no evidence to back that up. Where charges have been brought in and where privatisation has taken place, what does happen is the cost of water goes up. Private water companies make a hell of a lot of money, and often investment in the infrastructure actually falls, actually declines. Britain, when they brought in charges and privatised, the investment in the water infrastructure reduced, didn't increase.
We'll go to the audience in a moment on the water issues. But Cormac, can I go to you? Fianna Fáil were the people who agreed with the Troika to introduce water charges.